Are you in the market for a new camera and wondering which type of image sensor is better, CMOS or CCD? Well, look no further because in this video, we're going to dive into the world of image sensors and give you a comprehensive breakdown of the differences between CMOS and CCD. If you're a photography buff or a professional videographer, you know that the image sensor is the heart of your camera. It's responsible for capturing the light that creates your images and videos. So it's essential to know which type of sensor will give you the best results for your specific needs. We'll start by taking a closer look at CMOS sensors, their advantages, disadvantages, and how they compare to CCD sensors. We'll also examine the strengths and weaknesses of CCD sensors and how they stack up against CMOS. Whether you're looking to capture stunning landscapes, shoot action-packed sports footage, or take breathtaking portraits, the choice of the sensor can make a huge difference. So, buckle up and get ready to learn everything you need to know about CMOS versus CCD sensors in this informative video. When it comes to digital imaging technology, two popular options are complementary metal-oxide semiconductor, or CMOS, and charge-coupled device, or CCD sensors. Both of these technologies have their strengths and weaknesses, and choosing the right one for your application can be a challenge. Whether you are a photographer, videographer, or just someone interested in digital imaging, understanding the nuances of CMOS and CCD sensors can help you make informed decisions when it comes to capturing stunning visuals. You see, for years, there has been a passionate debate among photographers and camera enthusiasts over which technology reigns supreme for camera sensors, CMOS or CCD. Slowly but surely, CMOS technology began its journey towards industry dominance throughout the 2000s. By the end of the decade, it became abundantly clear that CMOS was the clear winner for both stills and video. Despite this, the debate has persisted, causing confusion and uncertainty among those seeking to understand the differences between these two sensor technologies. Our goal is to provide a clear and concise explanation of the scientific differences in language that is accessible and jargon-free, while also delving into some of the common talking points that have been circulating online for nearly two decades. However, we understand that this is a complex issue that may cause confusion for some. That's why we'll do our best to provide a comprehensive and detailed explanation while still keeping things engaging and interesting. Imagine you're holding a digital camera in your hand. You know that when you take a picture, the camera records the light that comes through the lens and turns it into a digital image. But have you ever wondered how this process actually works? Inside the camera, there is a sensor, a small device that acts like the eye of the camera. This sensor is made up of millions of tiny squares called silicon photosites, or pixels. When light enters the camera lens and hits these pixels, something amazing happens. The photons from the light interact with the atoms in the silicon substrate, causing electrons to get kicked into higher energy states and move through the structure. But here's the thing. These pixels can only measure the intensity of the light that hits them. They can't actually tell what color the light is. In order to capture color information, the sensor needs a color filter array CFA installed over it. The most common type of CFA is called an RGB Bayer mosaic, which has a pattern of red, green, and blue filters arranged in a grid over the pixels. With this filter in place, each pixel can now capture a specific color value. But how does the sensor actually turn this information into a digital image? This process is called reading the sensor, or a readout, and it's when the physical electric activity from the sensor is transformed into digital data. Both CCD and CMOS sensors work in the same way. They both use silicon photosites to measure the light that enters the camera. But the way in which they capture and translate this light into digital images is what sets them apart. And it's this process that allows us to capture beautiful, vibrant photos that capture the essence of the moment. In a CCD sensor, each pixel is like a tiny bucket that collects photons when light strikes it during exposure. The photons cause electrons to be released, which amass at the pixel, creating a charge that is constrained by electrodes and vertical clocks. After exposure, the electrons migrate down the rows of the CCD, and the charge from each pixel is gathered along the way. Eventually, the charge reaches an amplifier at the end of the row, which measures the number of photons in each well and converts it into a voltage. From there, the signal goes through a gain stage and then to the ADC. To avoid vertical smear-type artifacts, most photographic CCD sensors require a mechanical shutter during readout. This means that live view is not possible as the sensor is read out one line at a time. However, early compact digital cameras with CCD sensors did have a form of live view, but with considerable lag and a low frame rate. This was due to the slow readout speed of the CCD chips, which took up to a second or more to bin and transfer each frame to the LCD screen or EVF. Despite the limitations, the quasi-live image was sufficient for framing static or mostly static subjects. It's worth noting that CCD cinema cameras use a different design. Let's switch gears to talk about CMOS sensors. Similar to what we discussed earlier, pixels on CMOS sensors also gather light, but things start to differ when it comes to the readout stage. In contrast to CCD sensors, each individual pixel on a CMOS sensor has its own readout circuit, a photodiode amplifier pair that transforms photons into voltage. Furthermore, every column of the CMOS sensor has its own ADC. This approach has some benefits. For instance, it reduces production costs as both the imaging sensor and ADCs are on the same silicon die, making the design more compact. This is particularly handy for compact cameras and smartphones. Moreover, CMOS sensors can read pixels out in parallel, making them faster, which is helpful for capturing high-speed action in videos or using a silent electronic shutter. For example, the Canon R5, R6, and Sony Alpha 1 cameras can read out the sensor quickly enough that moving objects don't appear warped or distorted. Additionally, CMOS sensors use less power and produce less heat than CCD sensors. One reason why CCD sensors couldn't be used in still cameras is because of their power and heat requirements. Sony's BSI technology further improved CMOS sensor performance in 2009 by moving the matrix behind the photodiodes. As a result, the amount of captured light increased by approximately half a stop. This change made CMOS technology even more superior to CCD sensors. CCD used to have some advantages over CMOS, but a lot of those have been fixed since CMOS took over. Let me tell you about the Nikon D1 from 1999. It had an APS-C CCD sensor that could produce 2.7 megapixel images. But here's the interesting part. The sensor itself had 10.8 million photosites, which is like having 10.8 megapixels. The great thing about CCD is that it's easy to combine charges from neighboring pixels using on-sensor pixel pinning. This makes the sensor more sensitive and improves the signal-to-noise ratio. You can do this with CMOS too, but only off-sensor, and you can't combine charges from neighboring photosites. Some stills cameras with in-body image stabilization offer pixel shift, which can be used to generate a high-resolution or true-color file of native resolution. However, on-chip pinning is still a better option. CCD sensors have a non-linearity that makes quarter tones and highlights more pleasing and natural. But this comes at the expense of a higher noise floor in the shadows, even at base ISO. It also requires precise exposure due to the unforgiving latitude of CCD sensors. But when done properly, many people think CCD produces more film-like image quality. The film is also non-linear with exceptional highlight latitude, but it has little tolerance for pushing shadows without aggressive pattern noise or color shifts. So when it comes to CCD and CMOS images, is there a difference? Absolutely. And not just in the way they're designed, but also in the output they produce. But here's the real question. Do those differences really matter? Well, it all depends on what you're looking for in your photography. If you're the kind of photographer who likes to use images straight out of the camera, then you'll probably find that CCD sensors produce more eye-catching and vivid pictures. They're punchier, more colorful, and generally require less adjustment than images produced by CMOS-based cameras. However, it's worth noting that there are many CMOS-based cameras that have excellent JPEG engines, such as Fujifilm and Olympus. On the other hand, If you shoot and process raw images, you can mimic the output of CCD sensors. Plus, the wider latitude of CMOS sensors allows you a much greater range of options. So while CMOS technology has outpaced CCD technology, at least for stills and video imaging, there's no reason to throw away your old CCD-based camera if you love the output it produces. I hope this video clears your doubts and confusion. Thank you so much, guys, for watching this video. And just before you leave, why not check this video out?